Hello, good afternoon to all. We will start the today's session, that is the operating system and administration lab. This is the lab session. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
हेलो हेलो
यस सर।
हेलो हेलो ओके सॉरी फॉर लिटिल बिट डिस्टर्बेंस फ्रॉम माय साइड बिकॉज देर इज अ नेटवर्क इशू. ओके सो गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. वी विल स्टार्ट आवर टुडे सेशन. दिस इज द लैबोरेटरी सेशन, ओएसएल लैब, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लैब. ओके सो वी विल सी द प्रैक्टिकल, व्हाट प्रैक्टिकल्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस ओएसएल लैब, दैट वी विल सी. And we will discuss what are the laboratory sessions, what are the programs we are going to learn under this OSL lab. So total there are 12 programs. Okay, total there are 12 programs under a Unix platform that you are going to implement throughout these sessions. What I will do, I will share with you the syllabus copy first of all, and then we will see one by one what we are going to do in this OSL lab. Okay. Okay, dear student, just wait for 2 minutes. I will share with you the syllabus copy. Okay. Dear, I hope that the syllabus is visible to you. Can you see the syllabus copy? Okay, see here. Now, okay. This is the operating system and administration lab. And we are having a 2 hours practical weekly. The term work is of 25 marks and practical examination. This is a practical examination. You have to implement the program here. So practical examination of 50 marks and total 75 marks are there. So see, what are the course objective of this OSL lab? So the first course objective is to learn and understand the basic and the advanced Linux command. Second one is to learn and understand the shell script, Perl script and Python script. Okay, to learn and understand the Perl script, Python script and shell script. Third one is to be able to add and delete the user and giving access right to the user in Linux platform. Next one is to be able to write and execute the C, C++, Java program under Linux platform. Fifth objective is to learn to be able to perform disk formatting and partitioning. Sixth one is to be able to install Linux operating system such as Ubuntu and Fedora. So dear students, you can see this is a very interesting and very knowledgeable objectives are there for this OSL lab. Okay, to learn and understand the basic as well as advanced command, to learn and understand the shell script, Perl script and the Python script, to learn and understand how to add and delete the user under Linux. Okay, then to learn and understand, to be able to write the C, C++ program under Linux platform, then to be able to perform the disk formatting, and to be able to install the Linux operating system such as Ubuntu and Fedora. These are the course objective of this lab. Now as we know that there are course outcome, so here you can see what are the course outcome of this lab. So after completion of this course, the student is able to create a program using Linux command. So that is the first outcome. Second outcome is student is able to understand the shell script, Perl script and Python script. Third outcome is student is able to create a program in C, C++, Java under Linux platform. Fourth one is student will able to understand the execution of the program under Linux platform. Fifth one is student is able to process control and its execution using different system calls. And last one is student is able to create formatting and disk formatting of Linux. So these are the outcome of this subject, that is actually laboratory. After completion of this lab, you will able to perform programs under Linux. Then a shell script, Python script, Perl script, C, C++, Java program, understand the execution of the program under Linux, process control and its execution using different system calls, create disk formatting and disk partitioning for Linux. So, and as well as the Linux installation, okay? So very important that everybody should be able to understand how to install the Linux in his or her system. That is also one of the outcome of this laboratory. So this is the course objective and outcome. Now what I will do, I will share with you the actual list of the program. See here, suggested list of assignment. So there are three group, group A, group B and group C. So you can see from group A, implement any four assignment. Here it is written. Is it visible to you? Okay, very good, very good. Group A is having near about five assignment and we have to perform any four assignments. Okay, group A. So implement any four assignments. See, the title of the first assignment is implementation of create, rename, and delete a file using Unix or Linux command and adding a user and access right. Okay, so the first program or the first assignment that we are going to implement in group A is implementation of create, rename, delete a file using Linux or Unix command. Okay, and also the sub part is there, that is adding the user and access right. So that is there. Second program is write a function to display the list of devices connected to your system, including the physical names and its instance number. Write a function using mount and unmount command to mount a device and unmount it. Very interesting. So probably you might surprise that this thing is new to you. What is the meaning of the assignment and how to implement it? This totally new to you, but don't worry, don't bother about this thing. We are going to learn this entire thing in this semester, and under Unix platform, under Linux platform, using shell script, using Python script, using C program, C++ program, Java program, all these things we are going to do in this semester with the help of this laboratory OSL, that is Operating System and Administration Lab. Okay. Third program you can see there, that is implement the command for creation and deletion of directory. Write a program to change the current working directory and display the node details for each file in the new directory. Okay, third one. Fourth one is process related command. List the process for the current shell, display the information about the process, display the global priority of the process, change the priority of the process with default arguments. Okay. And the fifth assignment is use the operating system commands to obtain the following result, like to print the name of the operating system, to print the login name, to print the host name. So these are the five assignments of the group A. And remember, we want to implement any four from this group A. So as I said, don't worry, don't bother, don't take any tension that how you are going to implement this program, what is required, all things I will teach you in this entire semester. Okay, you just attend the lectures, classes regularly, online sessions, and we will learn all these things, how to implement it under Linux platform. Correct. So now I will move towards group B. Group B. So again, you can see here it is written in group B, implement any four assignment. Okay, here you can see there is a implement any four assignments. So we will see what are the assignments. Now write a shell program. Write a shell program to convert the all lowercase letter in the file to uppercase letter. Okay, so you can understand this is a now group B is a advanced programs. Advanced means not a advanced, but it is related to the shell programs. We are going to write a shell script here under Linux. So that is a intention of group B. Under group B, we will learn how to write the shell programs. That first program is write a shell program to convert all lowercase letter in a file to uppercase letter. Now next program is what? Write a program to find the number of CPU cores and CPU manufacturer. So again, this is a shell program. Write a shell program to find the number of CPU cores and CPU manufacturer. Okay, then next program is the study assignment. And this is actually very important assignment as far as the lab is concerned. Study assignment on installation of Linux, that is the interactive installation. So we will learn how to install the Linux on your system, how to do the disk formatting and disk partitioning, and then how to install the actual Linux operating system. That is the aim of this assignment. Then next assignment is write a shell script that determines the period for which the specified user is working on the system. Okay, so the assignment will teach you shell script that determines how many times the number of user is log on a particular system. That we are going to learn in this system. Next assignment is write a shell script that access the file name, starting and ending line number of argument, and display all lines between the given line numbers. So that is again a shell script. So dear student, you can see group B is somewhat related to the shell script program. Here we are writing the shell programs. Okay, shell is a programming environment available in the Linux. And again, you have to implement, or rather we have to implement, okay, any four assignment from this group B. Okay, now I will move towards group C here. So here it is, group C. So again, you can see group C implement any four assignment. Okay, and what is the list of the assignment? Write a C or C++ script to display all logged in user. Write a C or C++ script to display all logged in user. This is the first title. Second title is C, C++ program. Actually, it is a write a C and C++ program to parent creating a child process by use of fork system call. So C and C++ program to parent creating the child process by use of fork system call. Then third one, Java program to identify the available memory in the system. We want to write a Java program to identify the available memory in the system. Next program is write a Java script to display all login user, count the number of login user, and write a program to create the foreground and the background process for a selected user and display its status. So this is the next assignment. Then you can see what is the next Python program to add two matrices. So we are going to write a Python program under Unix platform, Linux platform, to perform addition of two matrices. Next one is Python program to illustrate the different set operation. That is your set operation like union, intersection, then complement. Okay, all these are the set operation, classical set. That operation we are going to perform under Python program. And last one is write a Python program to generate the random numbers. Okay, so these are the programs in group C. And again, we are going to implement any four assignment from this group C. So here, this is the list of the assignment of this OSL lab, operating system and administration lab. So is it clear to everybody? And list of assignment is clear, or some more focus we need to give on these things? Okay, what is your opinion? How this lab is designed? What you are going to learn? Okay, what is your opinion? What is your, how this lab is designed? See here. Initially, if you see it clearly, initially what we are going to learn, we are going to learn group A, even though it is a program, but we are going to learn some of the commands, Linux and Unix command. And not only the command, we are going to implement a program using that Linux command. Okay, that is there in group A. Now, once you move towards group B, you can observe there we are writing a shell script. We are going to write a shell program here. Okay, so the nature of the program is changed now here. Initially, the commands are used, and now we are going to write a shell program. And if you observed in group C, we are going to write a program using C and C++, as well as Java, as well as Python. All these things are clubbed together, and we are going to write a program under a Unix platform in group C. So this is a very good balanced laboratory where you are going to learn each and everything related to the Linux administration and Linux programming. So Linux commands are there, shell scripts are there, C programs are there, C++ program is there, Linux installation is there, then disk formatting is there, disk partitioning is there, Python programs are there, Java programs are there. So it is a very good mixture. Rather, it is a very good coordination or the collection of all the programs and assignments that gives you the good flavor of this operating system and administration lab, isn't it? What do you think about this? What is your opinion? Okay. What is your opinion? Or any question or doubt is in your mind, if you want to ask about this syllabus, you can ask right now. Yes, anybody can unmute his or her mic and can share your views about this syllabus. Anybody? Yes, nobody want to share anything. No doubts, no questions, no any opinion. See here, Siddhant is asking something. What he is asking, see, Siddhant is saying, he said that, curious to become power user of Linux under guidance of you. Yes, definitely. Don't worry about that. Okay. Linux is a very interesting, this subject is a very interesting and challenging. Okay. I always like to teach this subject. Okay. Means yesterday I shared with you this from last 10 years I am teaching this subject to previously under Pune University. This was for final year students. Later on the syllabus change, it comes to the third year. Later on syllabus change, it comes to the second year. Now for this autonomous, we purposely add this subject for second year. Okay, so no doubt about that. I will do my level best to teach each and everything which is given there in a syllabus, not only in syllabus, out of the border, we will learn and understand many more concepts which are going in the industry, in the market. What are there, what are the practices and what are the culture which is used in industry, that definitely I will share with you. Then Darshan is saying that, are we going to learn the JavaScript, Java in this? Yes. See here now in a group C, you are having two program under Java platform. So what is the intention of this Java program? As well, you can see in the group C, we are having two program using C, C++, two program from Java, and three program from Python. So that is a collection. As I said, it is a collection of the languages. What is the intention? The intention is that student is able to execute the Java program under Unix platform. Student will be able to explain or execute the Python script under Linux platform. Student is able to execute the C, C++ program under Linux platform. So that is the intention. That's why we added here the Java program, Python program, C++ program, and the shell script is entirely different. That is also there in group B. So that is a very good combination. Definitely, definitely. Darshan, we are going to learn the JavaScript for this two program in this laboratory. Okay. Darshan is again saying that operations related to the OS, Unix and Linux. Yes. All the operations, process control, process management, memory management, then inter-process communication, synchronization, file system, file sharing, then device management, then all these operations related to the OS with respect to the Linux and Unix, we are going to learn under this unit. Okay. This is very interesting and challenging. Okay. Yeah, I will be very happy to teach this all entire thing to this subject, in this subject and to in this laboratory. Only the fact is that you need to pay attention. You need also, you also need to take the equal interest. Okay. So this should not be the case that only I am talking and you are not replying anything. This is an interactive session. So we need to interact with each other. आपको जो कुछ मालूम है वो आपको शेयर करना है, मुझे जो कुछ मालूम है वो मैं आपको शेयर करूंगा. सो दिस इज लाइक अ इंटरेक्शन. ओके. सो सो दैट वी कैन लर्न एंड शेयर मेनी मोर थिंग्स टू अदर्स. गौरव इज सेइंग दैट सर आर वी आर गोइंग टू इंस्टॉल द लिनक्स एज आवर मेन मशीन और एज अ वर्चुअल मशीन. गुड. यस. नाउ द इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी इज देयर. यू कैन परफॉर्म द वर्चुअल मशीन ऑल्सो और यू कैन ऑल्सो परफॉर्म द ड्यूअल बूट. Okay, that it means your Windows will be there and the Ubuntu or the Fedora will be also there. That is a dual boot process. So virtually also you can do it. Okay, so all these options are open to us. We will learn here the how to make your laptop or machine virtual for OS, Linux OS, or how to make it dual boot. Okay, probably what my suggestion is that here. Memory management plays the crucial role whenever the virtual machine is installed. So your laptop, if it is of high configuration in terms of RAM, okay, then the virtual environment is good. Rather, now this subject is a full-fledged subject in your syllabus. My suggestion is that rather than going for virtual machine, try to install the Linux and make the laptop as a dual boot laptop. Okay, and that we will teach how to install and how to make the system dual boot. Okay. Suhash is asking, sir, which other OS are the best other than Ubuntu? See, here Ubuntu is very user friendly and widely used. Fedora is there. Okay. Fedora is there, Red Hat is there, Mint is there, SUSE is there. Okay, number of flavors are there. Means Fedora, Red Hat, Mint, SUSE, all these are the very famous and used OS. Ubuntu is good for you. Fedora is also good. So we are going to use Ubuntu here. Okay, Fedora is also installed in our laboratory. So rather than this Ubuntu, Fedora, Red Hat Linux, then SUSE OS, SUSE, Mint is there, Parrot OS is also good option. Yes, Gaurav is saying Parrot OS. So I said there are many more flavors. There are many flavors of this operating system. What is our intention? We must learn to understand the operating system and administration. Okay. That we will definitely do under this laboratory. So any other thing that we would like to share with us? Akshay is saying that can we use WSL? WSL. Can you explore something about this WSL? Akshay? Yes, Akshay. Yes, means that is a Windows environment. Windows environment. Actually, it is a Windows subsystem for Linux. Okay, WSL. That is actually the Windows subsystem for Linux. Under that, what we are going to do, it is a compatibility layer for running the Linux library executables. So that's what I am saying. Making the dual boot machine means keeping the Linux aside with Windows 10. That is a good option. But rather than using the virtual OS, that is also good. But what will happen as your application will increase in third year and final year, you are going to install the many more softwares on your machines, laptop. So probably it will give some low speed for execution of the programs once it is made virtual or this like this WSL, Windows Subsystem for Linux. Okay. So this option is also there. Okay. It is like a virtual Siddhant is correct. It is like a virtual machine. Okay. It is actually the Windows subsystem. So that option is also open. But what in our syllabus, the installation that I will teach you, that is a dual boot system, dual boot installation. How to install the Ubuntu on your laptop along with Windows 10. Okay. That we are going to learn. Yes. Other than this, so now I think that syllabus is clear to everybody. Is it clear to everybody what we are going to, how many program we are going to implement in the entire semester? Can anybody tell the number of figure? What is the figure? How many program assignments you are going to implement? 12. Very good. We are going to implement 12 programs, 12 assignments in this entire lab. So 4 from group A, 4 from group B, and 4 from group C. So total 12 assignments are there in your term work file. Okay. And practical examination is based on these 12 assignments. Anything other you want to focus on this syllabus? Yes. Now, what we will do, we will start our actual laboratory with the introduction to the Linux command, Linux and the Unix command. Okay. So now, we will see some of the basic commands first of all, and then the advanced commands. See what I will do. I will share with you the terminal window. Terminal window, you know what is mean by terminal window? Aditi is saying that, sir, we want to select a 12 practical as per our convenience. Yes, it is better to select the 12 practical as per your convenience. That is no doubt about that. But first of all, as per the need of the syllabus, we will complete our 12 assignment as per the sequence whatever I have made, and later on you are free to select your 12 assignments also, no doubt about that. Okay, so you can select your own assignments also. And first of all, I will complete the syllabus from my side. Okay, 12 assignments I will complete, and later on if you feel that, sir, I need to learn and understand this another assignments also, that is in your 12 group, then we will learn, or I will explain that assignment also. Is it correct, Aditi? Yes. So now what I will do, I will share with you the terminal window. Before that, what is mean by terminal window? What is the terminal window? What do you think? What is the terminal window? Yes, anybody? Terminal window means the prompt, the command prompt. The terminal is like a CMD controller. Yes, correct. Where we run the program. Terminal is the interface where we can execute the commands. Correct. Very good. So continuously, I appeal to everybody. Whatever the messages the students are placing on the chat box, you also read that message. It's a very good sharing of the information with this session. So Gaurav is saying that it is responsible to execute the instruction or command and return the output. Correct. So the terminal window, that whatever you are saying is absolutely right. It is a terminal where the program can be executed or the command can be executed. It is a command line controller. That is absolutely right. It is able to execute the programs and instruction and return the output. That is also right. So that terminal we required for execution of the Linux command. Okay. As a morning in the theory session, I discussed with you the Linux, that who was responsible for development of Linux? Can anybody share the name of the scientist who invented the Linux operating system? Who invented the Linux operating system? Yes, Linus Torvald. Linus Torvald is the name of the scientist who invented the Linux operating system. Okay, in 1991. In 1991. Before that, the Unix operating system was invented by Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie with the help of C language. The entire Unix is designed using C language, C compiler. So, before 1991, the most of the things of this Linux operating system or the Linux operation, which took place with the help of command line only, with the help of command line. No GUI were there. But after 1991, this Linux comes in picture, and a very user-friendly environment was provided where we can interact with our operating system with the help of that interface. That comes in picture as a part of this Linux. But terminal window plays the important role. Even though Linux comes in picture, terminal window is having a very important part. So every your program, command, instruction is executing on this terminal window. So what we will do, I will share with you the terminal window. Okay. I will stop this presentation. And I will share the terminal window with you. Just a minute. Yes. Now the terminal window is visible to you. Right now I am in the Ubuntu. Okay. Terminal window visible to you? Yes. Okay, very good. See here. So this is the terminal window where we can able to execute the command. Okay. Now dear students, see here. This terminal window where we can write commands. So each terminal window is having a unique number. What is that number? So that number we can extract that number with the help of command tty. Okay, see here, I can write here tty. Tty is the command that will tell you which terminal window you are executing. Okay, see here. So it is like a slash, it gives the output slash dev slash pts and slash zero. Okay, so that means it is a terminal window whose number is zero. Whose number is zero. Okay, clear to everybody? Slash dev slash pts. Okay. And slash zero. So what is this slash dev slash pts? So slash dev slash pts, it dev stand for device. Dev stand for device. And pts is the folder in that device directory. So slash dev slash pts, it contains the entire corresponding to the devices. Okay. This is a special directory that can be created dynamically by Linux kernel. Okay. The contents of the directory vary with time and reflect the state of running system. So like it is a entire entries corresponding to that devices. Slash dev slash pts. Slash dev slash pts. That gives the information about that device. Contain the entries corresponding to that device. So device means what? Now, as I am connected with the help of this terminal, terminal is the device. Terminal is act as a device to this operating system. Now, what I will do, I will show you one more thing here. Now I will open one more terminal window. Okay, so see, I open one more terminal window. So there are two terminal window now. Okay, so again I give terminal. So you can see this one is the first. Okay, where we have written tty, and this one I have opened new window. So again I give tty. Okay, tty. So you can notice there, now what is the number here? Slash dev slash pts slash one. Okay, so that means a second device. That means now I have opened second device. Are you getting what I am saying? I will open one more window. See here, now the third window I open, I again give tty command, tty. So what is the number here? Slash dev slash pts slash two. Okay, so what I will do, I will open one more window. So now the fourth window I open, tty. Okay, tty stand for terminal. So what is the number here? Three. So how many window I open? I open four window. The first window is having the number zero. Second window is having the number one. Third window is having the number two. And the fourth window is having the number three. If I open one more window, so again I can check the name of that window with the help of tty. So I will get slash dev slash pts slash four. Okay, samajh mein aa raha hai aapko? Are you getting what is happening here? Are you getting what is happening here? Okay, samajh mein aa raha hai kya ho raha hai aapko? Okay, the first command that we discuss is the tty. Tty ka matlab kya hai? TTY का मतलब जानने के लिए मैं आपको और एक कमांड यहाँ पे दिखाऊंगा, और एक कमांड. सो सपोज अभी वी आर न्यू टू द लिनक्स, आप सब लोग लिनक्स के लिए नए हैं ऐसे हम सोचते हैं. अभी सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट दे नो द लिनक्स फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. ओके, दैट इज गुड थिंग, दैट इज गुड इफ यू आर हैविंग अ नॉलेज अबाउट लिनक्स. बट मेजोरिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर न्यू टू द लिनक्स. सो देर इज अ वेरी गुड कमांड अवेलेबल इन लिनक्स, दैट इज अ मैन कमांड, M-A-N, man. Man stand for manual. Manual. Manual means a help. Help about the Linux command. So, मुझे अभी ये देखना है TTY का मतलब क्या है. ओके सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल गिव द कमांड मैन मैन स्पेस TTY. सब लोगों को दिखाई दे रहा है. आर यू सीइंग ऑन योर स्क्रीन. सब लोग देख रहे हैं क्या, सब लोग देख रहे हैं स्क्रीन पे. यस. सो मैंने क्या किया, आई हैव गिवन द मैन कमांड यूजिंग टर्मिनल विंडो. और मैंने क्या किया, मैन स्पेस TTY. तो मुझे क्या करना है, मुझे TTY का मतलब क्या है वो अंडरस्टैंड करना है. तो इफ आई प्रेस एंटर, नाउ यू कैन सी. सो हियर TTY का मतलब दिया है. TTY का मतलब क्या है आप पढ़ सकते हैं. TTY प्रिंट द फाइल नेम ऑफ द टर्मिनल कनेक्टेड टू द स्टैंडर्ड आउटपुट. ओके पढ़ा आपने सब लोगों ने. दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ TTY. TTY इज द कमांड विच इज यूज टू प्रिंट द फाइल नेम ऑफ द टर्मिनल कनेक्टेड टू द इनपुट, कनेक्टेड टू द स्टैंडर्ड इनपुट. ओके सो दिस इज द TTY इज द वन कमांड दैट इज एक्चुअली यूज टू प्रिंट द फाइल नेम ऑफ अ टर्मिनल. तो मैंने चार टर्मिनल विंडो ओपन किए थे, चार टर्मिनल विंडो मैंने ओपन किए, चार ही को अलग अलग नाम दिया गया. फर्स्ट टर्मिनल विंडो इज /dev/pts0. सो आई कैन शो यू. सो सी हियर, दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट /dev/pts. नाउ सेकंड /dev/pts1. नाउ थर्ड /dev/pts2. दिस इज थर्ड /dev/pts3. This is fourth where I am writing this man command. Okay, so even you can press the, you can come out from this. Okay, so where you can see /dev/pts4. So this is the one command TTY which print the file name of a terminal window. Okay, और ये सब information कहाँ पे store रहती है? All this information is stored in /dev. सुबह मैंने आपको फाइल सिस्टम के बारे में थोड़ा सा बताया क्लास में. So what is a slash? What do you mean by slash? What is a slash in file system? What is a slash in file system? Root directory. Correct. Very, Gaurav, very good. Gaurav is saying it is a root. Darshan also saying correct. So it is a root. तो रूट मतलब क्या है कि मेरा जो लैपटॉप है, मेरा लैपटॉप में जो फाइल सिस्टम मैंने इंस्टॉल की है, ओके विद द हेल्प ऑफ लिनक्स. जब आप ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम यूज करते हैं तो ऑटोमेटिकली वहां पे फाइल सिस्टम आती है. आपने विंडोज इंस्टॉल किया तो विंडोज फाइल सिस्टम आएगी, आपने लिनक्स इंस्टॉल किया तो लिनक्स फाइल सिस्टम आएगी. सो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के साथ फाइल सिस्टम इज बाय डिफॉल्ट देयर. तो जो फाइल सिस्टम अभी लिनक्स पे अवेलेबल है मेरे लैपटॉप में, तो उसका जो रूट डायरेक्टरी है दैट इज नथिंग बट स्लैश. ओके स्लैश, स्लैश स्टैंड फॉर रूट, रूट डायरेक्टरी. तो उस रूट डायरेक्टरी में क्या है, डेव नाम का एक फोल्डर है, DEV, डेव स्टैंड फॉर डिवाइस. ओके रूट में डिवाइस मतलब DEV, डेव नाम का एक फोल्डर है. उस फोल्डर में और एक फोल्डर है PTS नाम का, PTS. और PTS नाम में फिर मैंने जो चार विंडो ओपन किए हैं उनका नंबर है. सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल शेयर विद यू द एक्चुअल फाइल सिस्टम इन माय लैपटॉप. ये ऐसा अवेलेबल है कि नहीं ये हम चेक करेंगे. ओके क्लियर. नाउ आई गो टू द होम कंप्यूटर डेव देन PTS. ओके सीयर. सो प्रोबेबली आई नीड टू शेयर विथ दिस, मुझे ये आपके साथ शेयर करना पड़ेगा. सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल शेयर दिस थिंग विथ यू. आई विल स्टॉप दिस and I will share my folder. Okay, share this. Okay. Here. Now, यस तो मैंने क्या किया, मेरे मशीन का जो फाइल सिस्टम है, जिसको आप विंडोज में कहते हैं माई कंप्यूटर, विंडोज में माई कंप्यूटर कहते हैं, वो आपके साथ शेयर किया है लिनक्स का, उसे कहते हैं फाइल सिस्टम। ओके, सो यू कैन सी अंडर कंप्यूटर, सो दिस इज कंप्यूटर इज द रूट। तो वहां पे आप देख सकते हैं डेव, डेव का एक फोल्डर है, सबको दिखाई दिया डेव, मैंने उसे ऊपर क्लिक किया है, डेव स्टैंड फॉर डिवाइस। ओके, आपने देखा डेव फोल्डर, यस और नो? यस। तो अगर मैंने डेव पे क्लिक किया डबल क्लिक, देन इट ओपन सब फोल्डर्स वेयर यू कैन सी पीटीएस है क्या, पीटीएस, यस पीटीएस इज देयर, सी पीटीएस, पीटीएस दिखाई दिया सबको। पीटीएस पे अगर मैंने डबल क्लिक किया तो आप देख सकते हैं जीरो फर्स्ट टर्मिनल, सेकंड टर्मिनल, थर्ड टर्मिनल, फोर्थ टर्मिनल एंड फिफ्थ टर्मिनल। तो हमने अभी क्या किया था, चार टर्मिनल, पांच टर्मिनल ओपन किए थे, उसकी रन टाइम इंफॉर्मेशन स्लैश डेव स्लैश पीटीएस फोल्डर में अवेलेबल है। समझ में आ रहा है आपको? आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? ये जो कुछ मैं आपको दिखाई दिखा रहा हूं, ये आपको समझ में आ रहा है क्या? हाँ, यस, वेरी गुड। सो दिस इज द टीटीवाई, टीटीवाई इज द कमांड दैट इज बेसिकली यूज टू डिस्प्ले द कंटेन द करस्पॉन्डिंग इंट्रीज टू द डिवाइस, टीटीवाई द फाइल नेम। ओके, तो हमने देखा अभी। ओके, सो नाउ आई विल स्टॉप दिस एंड आई विल अगेन गो टू टर्मिनल। ओके, तो यू कैन सी, तो मैं क्या करता हूँ अभी, ये जो चार नंबर का टर्मिनल है, दिस फोर्थ नंबर टर्मिनल आई विल क्लोज। हाउ आई कैन क्लोज, आई विल एग्जिट, टाइप एग्जिट, एग्जिट। सो हियर नाउ ओनली थ्री रिमेन्स, मीन्स द फोर्थ वन इज डिलीटेड, फिफ्थ वन इज डिलीटेड एंड थ्री रिमेन्स। सो अगेन इफ आई गो टू द रूट फोल्डर, ओके, सो यू कैन सी देयर स्लैश डेव स्लैश पीटीएस, दिस थ्री इज रिमेन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल डू, आई विल क्लोज ऑल दिस थिंग्स एंड देन आई विल शो यू द पीटीएस। सो एग्जिट, 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 नाउ ओनली वन रिमेन। इफ आई क्लोज दैट एग्जिट, ओके, सो ऑल टर्मिनल विंडो गॉन। नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल स्टॉप द शेयरिंग एंड आई विल शो विथ यू द कंप्यूटर फाइल सिस्टम। ओके, हियर इट इज। ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी कंप्यूटर, सो हियर इट इज अ डिवाइस फोल्डर, डिवाइस, डबल क्लिक पीटीएस फोल्डर एंड इन पीटीएस नाउ नो विंडो इज देयर बिकॉज आई क्लोज ऑल द टर्मिनल, आई क्लोज ऑल द टर्मिनल, सो देर इज नो एनी इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दैट टर्मिनल। सो दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ टीटीवाई। समझ में आया आपको सबको? आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? आज जो कुछ हमने देखा टीटीवाई के बारे में, ये आपको समझ में आया क्या?
यस सर।
यस, वेरी गुड। दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट। आई अगेन ओपन टर्मिनल फॉर 2 मिनट्स एंड देन वी विल कंक्लूड। ओके, टुडेज लेक्चर, टुडेज लैब, सी हियर। आई अगेन शेयर द टर्मिनल। Okay, so present now. Okay, means now see here, terminal, yes, alarm. Okay, so this is the terminal. And where you can see, I have written man TTY. Okay, so what is the use of TTY? TTY is used to print the file name of a terminal connected to the standard input. Okay, if I press Q, so if I give here TTY, then it gives the information slash dev slash pts slash zero. And I can open multiple terminal here. I can open second terminal TTY. Okay, I can open third terminal TTY. I can open many like this. You can open number of terminal in the same window. Okay, or what is the another important point of this? You can execute different program in different window. Okay, समझ में आ रहा है? आप डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम डिफरेंट विंडो में एग्जीक्यूट कर सकते हैं। इसका मतलब क्या है कि इट इज अ डिफरेंट जॉब आर एग्जीक्यूटेड ऑन सेम कंप्यूटर। तो मैं अलग तरीके से आपको बताता हूं कि इट इज अ मल्टीपल टास्क एग्जीक्यूटेड ऑन सेम कंप्यूटर। सो इट इज व्हाट? इट इज अ मल्टीटास्किंग। समझ में आया आपको? सो इट इज अ मल्टीटास्किंग। आप एक ही मशीन पे मल्टीपल टास्क एग्जीक्यूट कर सकते हैं। कैसे कर सकते हैं? मैंने आपको बताया कि आप टर्मिनल विंडो ओपन करके 10 टर्मिनल विंडो ओपन करके आप 10 प्रोग्राम साइमल्टेनियसली रन कर सकते हैं। दैट इज अ मल्टीटास्किंग। सिमिलरली आप क्या कर सकते हैं? हर एक टर्मिनल विंडो में आप सेपरेट यूजर को एक्सेस दे सकते हैं। सो इट बिकम अ मल्टी यूजर सिस्टम। मतलब टर्मिनल विंडो जीरो में एक यूजर काम करेगा, टर्मिनल नंबर वन में अलग यूजर काम करेगा, टर्मिनल नंबर थ्री में कोई अलग यूजर काम करेगा। सो इट बिकम अ मल्टी यूजर सिस्टम। एंड वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ यूनिक्स इज मल्टी यूजर मल्टी टास्किंग ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। यस और नो? यूनिक्स इज मल्टी यूजर मल्टी टास्किंग ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। सो यस, सो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल स्टॉप हियर। ओके, आई विल शेयर विद यू द लिंक ऑफ योर अटेंडेंस फॉर ओएसएल लैब। You mark your attendance there after completion of your next lecture. Probably the next lecture is waiting there. So hope जो कुछ मैंने बताया आपको आज practical lab के बारे में वो आपको समझ में आया है। Are you getting what I am saying? समझ में आया सबको? Yes, very good. Okay, so what we will do? We will stop here. Afterwards, you mark your attendance. Okay, I will end the session. You join to the another lecture session, online session. Thank you very much. Good day.